Hi everybody, it is Let's Talk Monday. Tomorrow is the 4th of July, so I hope everyone has some great, fantastic plans for their day with either your family or your friends. If you have to work like I am, I'm sorry, I apologize. But let's not forget to thank everyone who has served our great country to give us the freedom that we have today to live in this great country, independent in the United States of America. So, as we're celebrating Independence Day, sorry, can't speak today for some reason. Anyway, so this week, we kind of warned you guys that this week was going to be one of those sensitive subjects, that we were going to have a 16 and older audience, because we've had a couple of questions about this. Particularly, like I said, I don't like to give you guys' names out because I don't believe that when y'all send me messages, I believe that y'all do that anonymously, like y'all are asking me questions. And, I know that you like for me to answer these questions out here, but I don't feel comfortable like saying your names, just in case y'all want to keep that anonymity, if I can say that correctly. So, one of the questions I had this week was from a girl who had a few questions about whether her cycle was normal or not. So, let's talk about TS and cycles because this is something that, especially with us being on hormones, they can be really random. Sometimes they could be abnormal if you're not on the correct hormones and, things like that. Sometimes they can come at different times. You just never know. So let's talk about what is normal and what is not normal and what needs to be taken care of. So, first off, the normal cycle, we'll talk about an adult and then a young teen because I know a lot of parents watch this and I've had one mother ask me questions about her daughter. So, we're going to talk about young teens and the adults. Now, for adults, the typical cycle is about 21 to 35 days. Now, of course, we all know 35 days is that lovely time of the month that we really love, that Mother Nature just really loves us, and we really love that time of the month. We say that with all sarcasm implied. So, for a young teen, this is typically about 21 to 45 days. Now, of course, if you're late, there's many reasons why you could be late or you could be early. You just never know. So some of the problems you can have, if you have any issues, always go to your doctor. Always go to your gynecologist and talk to them about your issues. There's many apps on your phone now that can actually help you track this. But also, if you're on hormones like I am, which a lot of us are, I typically know when mine's coming. So that helps me out a lot. So that way, you keep it regulated and everything, and you're kind of prepared for it. So, 35 days should be the normal, let's say, cycle, our lovely time of the month. Now, if it lasts longer than that, you need to go to a doctor. There might be an issue. There's two we're going to talk about today, because they're going to be more common, especially if you're on hormones. One's called amenorrhea. Sorry, amenorrhea. This is a lack of menstruation. Now, this happens if your hormones are too low. This can happen if you're in the early stages of being pregnant. There's many, many reasons why. And so if you have that, you need to go to a doctor, and that's called amenorrhea. So look that up. And then we're also going to talk about dysmenorrhea, which is the painful periods. Now this is caused by too much progesterone. And so that is the cramping. That's your cramping, and yes, they hurt. Later this week for our ladies' night, we're gonna have our little rants about this, and we're gonna give each other some tips about how to get over this and things like that. Like I said, I like to keep these on the medical side. So if you have any questions about the medical side, we're gonna take those tonight. And like I said, ladies' night, that's gonna be our ranting and talking about how much we love this. So it can be caused by endometriosis. This can be PCOS. This can be, like I said, having too much progesterone. And so these are things you want to look out for. So if you have any of these problems, you want to talk to your doctor and you want to get your hormones tested because if you're taking too much estradiol or maybe you're not taking enough estradiol, maybe your progesterone level isn't correct, maybe that needs to be upped or lowered. And so that's something you typically want to look for. Now, this should start, this lovely cycles that we love. They should start 2 to 3 years after breast development. So that's going to answer some of the questions I've gotten from some of the moms about, when should I have my daughter on hormones? When should she start having her periods? Things like that. Usually it's about 12. 12 is the normal, is the average age for any girl to have her period. So, and that's typically 2 to 3 years after she starts breast development. So that's something that you want to look for and talk about with your doctor. So if you've had any questions about that, there's your answer. And like I said, always, if you have questions about this afterwards, always message me. I'm always here and I love reading your questions. I love answering your questions. I love doing my research. I know I've been a little, not much on Facebook now that I've been working, but like I said, as soon as I get off work or something, I have no problem messaging you girls back. So those are some of the problems we're going to talk about. And endometriosis, that's not too common in girls with TS. Not that it doesn't happen, but that's something that you're not typically gonna see, if that makes sense. You're not typically gonna see that in girls with TS. So that's not something you're gonna be too worried about. Not that it doesn't happen, but it's not that common, if that makes sense. So, and I know I say that a lot. So anyway, but that's what we're going to talk about today as far as that is concerned. Now, the reason that I talk about the hormones and getting them started at the proper age, that's really going to help because when your body starts when you're supposed to, that really helps jumpstart a lot of other hormones. It's not just your estrogen, your progesterone, it's so many others. It helps jump up your growth hormone, your thyroid, things like that. Like it puts your whole hormone system into balance. It really helps you out as a woman. So that's something that you really want to think about. And especially if you're talking about your daughter starting hormones, that's something you want to have that conversation about, you and your husband or partner, with your doctor, with your daughter, of course. This is something that is very typical for a woman. And so I know for us having TS, it's not going to help us as far as fertility is concerned because I have had some questions about that. It doesn't help as far as fertility. Now, if you want to do IVF, if you're a good candidate for it. Now, if you have TS and you have a heart condition, you're not a good candidate for IVF. But if you don't have a heart condition and you are a good candidate for IVF, if your doctor clears you for it, you need to have periods. And whether you are have IV or can do IVF or not, it's good for your body. It's good for the female body. It's something that is natural, that is supposed to happen. And like I said, it helps jumpstart, a lot of different things. So it's very important. Even though it's not fun and I don't like Mother Nature, I have many pleasantries I would like to exchange with her at times, but it's something that's natural for us. So we're gonna wrap up Let's Talk Monday for today. Don't forget to join us on this Thursday. We're gonna be doing Ladies Night on Thursday. Thursday seemed to be a day for me. So we're gonna do it this Thursday, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. We're gonna do TS. We're gonna do our little rant, at least our personal rants, about this lovely time of the month. And we're also gonna be talking about some other issues with TS. Keep messaging me like some ideas and your questions about TS and about the medical side, things you want to talk about for ladies' night, whether it's personal life with TS, whether it's issues you've had at school or work or driving or anything really. Marriage, I know we've talked about doing a marriage one. I really want to get into a certain part of marriage, but I really want us to get more in depth, and I want to do an older audience for that. So, anyway, we're going to talk about that one night. Have a great day, everybody. Be safe tomorrow for the 4th of July. Be careful with the fireworks. Drink wine if you're legal. We'll see Thursday, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time for Ladies' Night. Love you, girls. Bye.